Well, another good win for Ricky Walden. Ricky, you're now into the third round. What do you make of the new format?
Yeah, it's different, you know. It's not what we're used to with the UK Championships, but I think everyone's sort of settling in now and getting used to how it's going, so it's all good.
Always quite nice to get over the potential banana skins of the first couple of rounds. We've seen Marco Fu go out. There was a great performance from the young Shane Castle against Mark Selby yesterday, 15 years of age, and he took four frames off the defending champion. There's nowhere to hide at these tournaments for you big names anymore, is there?
No, it's tough. Obviously, you've got the young kids coming through. They're pretty sharp from the off. And the top players really need to settle in for the event, so you're always going to get a few upsets. Everyone needs to settle into the event two, three rounds, and then they're on the game then.
You had a good win in Doncaster earlier this season. Has that given you a little bit of oomph and a little bit of momentum going into the second half of the season?
Yeah, it's been a poor first half of the season, really. I had that one win in Doncaster, but apart from that, I've not really done too much. So I've made a few changes and stuff, and I'm feeling pretty settled on the practice table at the moment. So hopefully this can be my time now, really.
And you had a good run at the UK's a couple of years ago. So, you know, are you starting to feel in the groove as though you might be able to put something decent together here?
Yeah, I think each round you go through, you feel a bit more settled. You know, I'm one of them players where if I can get settled on a run, then I can do some damage. So that's what I'll be looking to do, and I'm feeling good at the moment.
What about the next round? There is the possibility that you could face Mark Williams if he comes through a match against Rory McLeod. That would be quite a mouth-watering prospect. What's your head-to-head like with Mark?
I'd say we're pretty level, to be honest. I'm not quite sure. A couple of years ago when I did have the run, I played him in the quarterfinals, I think it was, and we had a good game there. So now it's going to be a tough game. Both similar players really like to attack and score pretty heavy, so hopefully it'll be a good contest.
On a slightly wider note, the fans who watch snooker and who've followed the sport for a long time will be aware of just how much the game is expanding globally. How tiring is it from the player's perspective? Because we've gone from six tournaments, you know, one every 6 or 7 weeks, and now you guys are on the road almost relentlessly. Does it get draining?
Yeah, I think it'll affect different players in different ways, really. It's gone are the days where you could sort of peak for a tournament, prepare for like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, get your practice game up and then go into the major event, where at the moment everyone's travelling, getting a little bit of practice here and there and sort of trying to get the game out on the match table. So it's sort of a momentum sport at the moment. If your game's good, then you're getting results in it, and if not, then you're sort of scrapping away to try and get back on track, really. So that's the most difficult thing, I would say.
And it would certainly ensure that people are match sharp.
Yeah, you're getting a lot more match sharp players out there. Everyone's sort of competitive now, and yeah, it's a tough game at the moment. Everyone's fighting for the trophies.
On a slightly lighter note, have you managed to see any of Steve Davis in the jungle?
Yeah, I've been watching him, to be fair. He's doing great so far. He's sort of everyone's pal over there, and he's sort of right in with a chance, I think. So, yeah, I've been tuned in.
Were you surprised when you found out that he was going down there? Because Steve is such a high-profile sportsman in the UK that he will have had multitudinous offers to do things like this in the past and always politely turned them down. But something obviously drew him in this year, and he clearly fancied it.
Yeah, maybe. It's a popular show and stuff, and it's also a good challenge, you know. So I wasn't too surprised, because he's such a competitor that he'll see this as a big competition for him as well, I think. So no, he's doing good.
Do you think he's got any chance of winning, or is it all set for a Joey Essex?
No, I think he has got a chance. Joey's obviously doing different class over there. He's sort of winning the public, isn't he? But no, I think if Steve does a few challenges and shows his personality a little bit more, then I think he'll have a great chance.
Well, watch that. A few early nights, and good luck against Rory or Mark, whoever gets through to face you in the next round.
Cheers, great stuff. Thank you. Cool.